Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 27, Problems with Oblique Shock. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the flow with oblique shock, and here we are going to solve few problems from the anionistic question paper in the oblique shock. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the flow with the oblique shock. And this will be the gas table which will be referring for solving problem in the gas dynamics, and the oblique shock, we have to refer table number 5.1 and 5.2. Also the tables for normal shock flow, we have to refer to solve problems in the oblique shock. Example number 1, an air stream at a Mach number of 2.0 is isentropically deflected by 10 degree in the clockwise direction. If the initial pressure and temperature are 98 kilonewtons per meter square and 97 degree Celsius, determine final state of air after expansion. So this is from May 2009 question paper. So we are given Mach number M1 equal to 2 and deflection angle is 10 degree. Pressure P1 equal to 98 kilonewtons per meter square and temperature T1 equal to 97 degree Celsius, which is 370 Kelvin. From oblique shock table 5.1 page number 66, at M1 equal to 2, delta equal to 10 degree and gamma equal to 1.4, the wave angle sigma equal to 39.3 degrees. The Mach number before the shock, Mx equal to M1 into sin sigma, which is equal to 2 into sin 39.3 equal to 1.27. Now from normal shock table 4.2 page number 52, at Mx equal to 1.27, gamma equal to 1.4, we take the properties My equal to 0.8015, Py by Px equal to 1.715, Ty by Tx equal to 1.172. Now the properties after the shock, P2 equal to Py equal to 1.715 into Px, which is 1.715 into 98 equal to 168.07 kilopascal. T2 equal to Ty equal to 1.172 into Tx, which is equal to 1.172 into 370 equal to 433.64 Kelvin, and M2 Mach number equal to My divided by sin sigma minus delta. So 0.8015 divided by sin of 29.3 minus 10 equal to 1.64. So the answer to the problem, pressure after the shock 168.07 kilopascal, temperature after the shock 433.64 Kelvin, and a Mach number after the shock 1.64. Example number 2, a jet of air at a Mach number of 2.5 is deflected inward at the corner of a curved wall. The wave angle at this corner is 60 degree. Determine the deflection angle of the wall, pressure and temperature ratio and final Mach number. So this is from May 2010 question paper. Mach number M1 equal to 2.5 and sigma equal to 60 degree. The wave angle is 60 degree and deflection angle of the oblique shock wave. So this is given by tan delta equal to m1 square sin square sigma minus 1 divided by 2 plus gamma m1 square plus m1 square into 1 minus 2 sin square sigma into cot sigma. So substituting the value of sigma, so tan delta equal to 2.5 square into sin square 60 minus 1 divided by 2 into 2 plus 1.4 into 2.5 square plus 2.5 square into 1 minus 2 into sin square 60 into 2 into cot 60 equal to 0.5584. So delta equal to tan inverse of 0.5584 equal to 29.18 degrees. The Mach number before the shock, Mx equal to M1 into sin sigma, which is 2.5 into sin 60 equal to 2.165. Now from the normal shock table 4.2 page number 53, at Mx equal to 2.165 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the property ratio P2 by P1 equal to Py by Px, which is 5.276, T2 by T1 equal to Ty by Tx, which is 1.825, My equal to 0.553 and M2 equal to My divided by sin of 60 minus delta, sin of 6 sigma minus delta, which is 0.553 divided by sin of 60 minus 29.18 equal to 1.08. So the answer to the problem, deflection angle is 29.18 degree, pressure ratio is 5.276, temperature ratio is 1.825 and final Mach number equal to 1.08. Example number 3, a gas of gamma equal to 1.3 at the pressure P1 equal to 345 millibar and temperature T1 equal to 350 Kelvin and M1 equal to 1.5 is isentropically expanded to 131 millibar. Determine the deflection angle, final Mach number and temperature of the gas. This is from May 2005 question paper. So, we are given P1 equal to 345 millibar, T1 equal to 350 Kelvin, M1 equal to 1.5, P2 equal to 131 millibar and gamma equal to 1.3. From isentropic table 3.1, page number 23, at M1 equal to 1.5 and gamma equal to 1.3, we take P1 by P1 equal to 0.284, T1 by T1 equal to 0.748. So, the pressure ratio at the exit, P2 by PO2 equal to P2 by P1 into P1 by PO1. P2 by P1. So, from the given data, so this is 131 divided by 345 into 0.284 equal to 0.108. Now, from isentropic table again, table number 3.1, page number 23, at the P2 by PO2 equal to 0.108 and gamma equal to 1.3, we take M2 equal to 2.115, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.598. Now, the Prandtl-Meyer function, omega of Mach number 1.5, M1 equal to 1.5. The equation is square root of gamma plus 1 divided by gamma minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1, M square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of M square minus 1. Substituting the value, omega at M1 equal to 1.5, 1.3 plus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 plus 1 into 1.5 square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of 1.5 square minus 1. So, calculating, first value is 2.77 into tan inverse of this value is 22 minus tan inverse of this value equal to 48.12. The answer is 12.82. Similarly, omega value at M2 equal to 2.115. Again, it is square root of gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 M square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of M square minus 1, substituting the values, square root of 1.3 plus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 plus 1 into 2.115 square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of 2.115 square minus 1. So, calculating 2.77 into 33.94 minus 61.78 equal to 32.23. Now, the deflection angle delta equal to omega of M1 minus omega of M2, which is 12.82 minus 32.23 equal to minus of 19.41 degrees. Temperature at the outlet T2 equal to T1 into T2 by TO2 into TO1 by T1. So, the 350 into 0.598 into 1 by 0.748 equal to 279.8 Kelvin. So, the answer to the problem, deflection angle is minus 19.41 degrees, final Mach number is 2.115, temperature of the gas is 279.8 Kelvin. Example number 4, a gas gamma equal to 1.3, pressure P1 equal to 345 millibar and temperature T1 equal to 350 Kelvin, pressure and Mach number M1 equal to 1.5 is isentropically expanded to 138 millibar. Determine the deflection angle, final Mach number and temperature of the gas. This is from May 2014 question paper. So, we are given P1 equal to 345 millibar, T1 equal to 350 Kelvin, M1 equal to 1.5, P2 equal to 138 millibar and gamma equal to 1.3. From isentropic table 3.1, page number 23, Mach number M1 equal to 1.5 and gamma equal to 1.3. We have P1 by P1 equal to 0.284, T1 by T1 equal to 0.748. Now, the pressure ratio at the exit, P2 by PO2 equal to P2 by P1 into P1 by PO1, which is 138 divided by 345 into 0.284 equal to 0.1136. Now, again from the isentropic table, for this pressure ratio 0.1136 and gamma equal to 1.3, we take M2 equal to 2.08 and T2 by TO2 equal to 0.606. Now, the Prandtl-Meyer function omega 1 at Mach number 1.5, M1 equal to 1.5, you write the equation, this is the Prandtl-Meyer function equation. So, square root of gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 into M square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of M square minus 1. Substituting numerical values, square root of 1.3 plus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 plus 1 into 1.5 square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of 1.5 square minus 1. So, calculating 2.77 into 22 minus 48.12 equal to 12.82. Now, for Mach number 2, omega value for Mach number 2, m2 equal to 2.08. So, again the equation gamma plus 1 square root of gamma plus 1 by gamma minus 1 tan inverse of square root of gamma minus 1 by gamma plus 1 into m square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of m square minus 1. So, substituting numerical values 1.3 plus 1 divided by 1.3 minus 1 into tan inverse of square root of 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.3 plus 1 into 2.08 square minus 1 minus tan inverse of square root of 2.08 square minus 1. So, calculating 2.77 into 33.37 minus 61.26 equal to 31.17. Now, the deflection angle delta equal to omega of m1 minus omega of m2. So, 12.82 minus 31.17 equal to minus 18.35 degrees. Temperature at the outlet T2 equal to T1 into T2 by T02 into T01 by T1, which is 350 into 0.606 into 1 by 0.748 equal to 283.56 Kelvin. So, the answer to the problem, deflection angle is minus 18.35 degrees, final Mach number is 2.08, temperature of the gas equal to 283.56 Kelvin. Example number 5, air approaches a symmetrical wedge, delta equal to 15 degree at a Mach number of 2. Determine for strong and weak waves, wave angle, pressure ratio, density ratio, temperature ratio, downstream Mach number. So, this is from November 2009 and May 2014 question paper. So, we are given m1 equal to 2 and delta equal to 15 degree. So, deflection angle of the oblique shock wave. So, tan delta equal to m1 square sin square sigma minus 1 divided by 2 plus gamma into m1 square plus m1 square into 1 minus 2 into sin square sigma into 2 cot sigma. So, substituting the value tan 15 equal to 2 square into sin square sigma minus 1 divided by 2 plus 1.4 into 2 square plus 2 square into 1 minus 2 into sin square sigma into 2 into cot sigma. Simplifying right hand side. So, left hand side is 0.2679 equal to 4 into sigma square. So, 2 square equal to 4 into sigma square sin square sigma minus 1 divided by numerical value is 11.6 minus 4 into sin square sigma into 2 into cot sigma. So, solving this equation by trial and error method, substituting a value of sigma and calculating the right hand side, and it should be equal to 0.269. So, doing by trial and error method, so by iteration we take sigma equal to 79.8 degree for strong wave. Why this is called a strong wave? The sigma value is closer to 90 degree. So, this is called as strong wave. Now, Mach number for the before the shock, mx equal to m1 into sin sigma, which is m1 in 2 into sin of 79.8 equal to 1.97. Now, from the normal shock table, table number 4.2, page number 53, at mx equal to 1.97, gamma equal to 1.4, we take the pressure ratio P2 by P1 equal to PY by PX equal to 4.361, T2 by T1 equal to TY by TX equal to 1.6635, rho 2 by rho 1 equal to P2 by P1 divided by T2 by T1, which is 4.361 divided by 1.6635 equal to 2.622, MY equal to 0.5825 and M2 equal to MY divided by sin of sigma minus delta, which is 0.5825 divided by sin of 79.8 minus 15 equal to 0.644. Now, the same equation, the earlier equation, we can solve, do the iteration for the weak wave, again the sigma. So, doing the iteration, now we find sigma equal to 45.3 for weak wave. So, this value is lower than the previous value or closer to less than, very much lower than the 90 degree. So, that is why it is called as weak wave. Now, for the weak wave, again the Mach number before the shock, mx equal to m1 sin sigma. So, 2 into sin of 45.3 equal to 1.42. So, for weak wave, mx equal to 1.42. Now, again from the normal shock table number 4.2, page number 52, at mx equal to 1.42, gamma equal to 1.4, we take the property ratio, P2 by P1 equal to PY by PX equal to 2.186, T2 by T1 equal to TY by TX equal to 1.267, rho 2 by rho 1 equal to P2 by P1 divided by T2 by T1 equal to 2.186 divided by 1.267 equal to 1.725, MI equal to 0.731 and M2 equal to MY divided by sin of sigma minus delta, which is 0.731 divided by sin of 45.3 minus 15 equal to 1.448. Now, answer to the problem for strong wave and weak wave. For strong wave, sigma equal to 79.8, pressure ratio 4.361, temperature ratio 1.6625, density ratio 2.622, Mach number is 0.644. And for weak wave, sigma equal to 45.3, pressure ratio 2.186, temperature ratio 1.267, density ratio 1.725 and Mach number equal to 1.448. Now, example number 6, an oblique shock wave occurs at the leading edge of a symmetrical wedge. Air has a Mach number of 2.1 and deflection angle delta equal to 15 degree. Determine the following for strong and the weak waves. Wave angle, pressure ratio, density ratio, temperature ratio, downstream Mach number. So, this is from November 2014 question paper. M1 equal to 2.1 and delta equal to 15 degree. These are all the given data. Now, the deflection angle of the oblique shock wave. So, delta tan delta equal to M1 square sin square sigma minus 1 divided by 2 plus gamma into M1 square plus M1 square into 1 minus 2 sin square sigma into 2 cot sigma. Substituting tan 15 equal to 2.1 square into sin square sigma minus 1 divided by 2 plus 1.4 into 2.1 square plus 2.1 square into 1 minus 2 into sin square sigma minus 1 into 2 into cot sigma. So, substituting value left hand side is 0.2679, right hand side 4.41 into sin square sigma minus 1 divided by 12.584 minus 4.41 into sin square sigma into 2 into cot sigma. So, solving by iteration, sigma equal to 65.16 for the strong wave and the Mach number before the shock Mx equal to M1 into sin sigma, which is 2.1 into sin 65.16 equal to 1.91. Now, the normal shock table 4.2, page number 53, at Mx equal to 1.91, gamma equal to 1.4, we take the property ratio P2 by P1 equal to PY by PX, which is 4.0895, T2 by T1 equal to TY by TX, which is 1.616, rho 2 by rho 1 equal to P2 by P1 divided by T2 by T1, which is 4.0895 divided by 1.616 equal to 2.53, MY equal to 0.594 and M2 Mach number of the exit, MY divided by sin of sigma minus delta, which is 0.594 divided by sin of 65.16 minus 15 equal to 0.77. Now, by iteration for the weak wave, sigma equal to 50.325 degree for weak wave. Now, Mach number before the shock, Mx equal to M1 into sin sigma minus 2 into sin 50.325 equal to 1.62. Now, we take the property from the normal shock table at Mx equal to 1.2 and gamma equal to 1.4. Now, the property ratio are P2 by P1 equal to PY by PX, which is 2.895, T2 by T1 equal to TY by TX, which is 1.402, rho 2 by rho 1 equal to P2 by P1 divided by T2 by T1, which is equal to 2.895 divided by 1.402 equal to 2.065, MY equal to 0.663, M2 equal to MY divided by sin of sigma minus delta, which is equal to 0.663 divided by sin of 45.3 minus 15 equal to 1.15. So, the answer to the problem for the strong wave, sigma equal to 65.16, P2 by pressure ratio is 4.0895, temperature ratio is 1.616, density ratio 2.53, Mach number M2 equal to 0.77. For weak wave, sigma equal to 50.325, pressure ratio 2.895, temperature ratio 1.402, density ratio 2.065 and the Mach number equal to 1.15. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion for additional problems in the oblique shock. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. Until then, bye-bye.